Respiration
In last class, we have discussed some points about respiration in lungs. Okay, next, conduction of air. Conduction of in plants. Usually, from the atmosphere, gases are entered into the plants through some special structure. There, for example, stomata, lenticels, surface of the root, understanding like this. Through this type of structures, gas, means mainly air, oxygen, is entered into the plant body. After entering into plant body, what will happen? What will happen? Let us see. First here,
I'm
here. This is tomato.
Observe the here a space. These are the surrounding cells. Now here atmospheric A. This is atmospheric. Here during the conduction process, what will happen? Listen carefully here. Leaf have large intercellular spaces or 8 spaces when compared to the other parts of the plant. Number of 8 spaces are present. Large 8 spaces are also present in leaf when compared to other parts. Here, all 8 spaces are 8 cavities are lined by water film. Means water. Observe carefully here. Water. This is here. Water. 8 cavities or 8 chambers or 8 spaces. They are lined by water film. Water. Here, what will happen now? Listen. Whenever atmospheric air is entered into the air cavity, observe carefully. For example, imagine this is air cavity here, this part, air cavity, listen carefully, this is air cavity. Now, whenever atmospheric air is entered into the air cavity, here means oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide, argon lattice. Here oxygen concentration, a percentage is 21% in atmosphere. Carbon dioxide is 0.03%. 0.03%. Nitrogen is inoxidable. Now these two are important. Okay, here nitrogen. We can discard the nitrogen because it is neither used by cells, neither used in cells, nor released from the cells. That is why we can discard this nitrogen. Now we want these two. Here oxygen 21%, carbon dioxide 0.03%. Okay, next, here inside of the cell are already we discussed this air chamber is lined by the water film. Okay, first what will happen? These gases are dissolved in water. These are dissolved in water film. Listen carefully. Means now this water contains the atmospheric gases. Oxygen 21%, carbon dioxide 0.03%. Okay, now observe here cells present adjacent to the air stage. Inside of the cell, what will happen? Respiration process occurs continuously. Listen carefully. Respiration process occurs continuously. As respiration process occurs continuously, oxygen is also utilized in the cell. Oxygen is utilized in the cell. Are understanding? And carbon dioxide is released inside of the cell. Okay. When oxygen is utilized, then oxygen concentration, oxygen concentration becomes low. Understanding? As carbon dioxide is released from the cell because of the respiration process, percentage or concentration of the carbon dioxide is the concentrations of oxygen and carbon dioxide gases present in atmospheric air. Means this water contains oxygen carbon dioxide. Yes or no? Yes. Oxygen. Listen carefully here. Oxygen. Is in high concentration when compared to these surrounding cells. Okay, when compared to the concentration of oxygen present in the surrounding cells. Next, concentration of carbon dioxide is low when compared to concentration of carbon dioxide in surrounding cells. In surrounding cells. Are you understanding? Observe carefully. Observe once all. Okay, now what will happen? Now, in this situation, diffusion process takes place. What? What? Diffusion process takes place. What is the diffusion? What is diffusion? Diffusion means movement of substances from high concentration to low concentration. Listen carefully here. Process of movement of substances or solute from high concentration to low concentration is called diffusion. It's called diffusion. Are you understanding? Observe carefully. Okay. What? Diffusion process. Process of movement of substances from high concentration to low concentration. Now here what happened? Listen carefully here. Because of diffusion process, oxygen is diffused from the high concentrated area to low concentrated area. From water film to adjacent cell. From this water film to adjacent cell. The same time, simultaneously, carbon dioxide is diffused from the high concentrated area to low concentrated area. Means from the surrounding adjacent cells into the water film. Water film. Observe, oxygen has entered into the cells. Carbon dioxide has released out of the cell. Means oxygen, carbon dioxide, these two are exchanged here. These two have exchanged. Are you understanding? Are you understanding? Observe carefully. Gaseous exchange process has occurred here. This is important one here. Okay, observe one. Okay, next will happen from the water film. Carbon dioxide is diffused into the atmospheric air. Okay, diffused into the atmospheric air. Then along with this atmospheric air, carbon dioxide released out of the leaf into the atmosphere. So what about the oxygen entered into the cell? Listen carefully here. So what about the entered oxygen? Understanding? What about the entered oxygen? Oxygen entered into the cell. This oxygen, listen carefully here, from the cell. For example, here this is another cell. Understanding? Here another cell. From this cell, they are again transported, or they are again diffused into the other cell. Means from here to here, actually from this cell, again diffused into the other adjacent cell. Like this. Means after some time, each and every cell of the leaf can get the oxygen. Can get the oxygen. Like this. Understanding? Observe one. All cells can get the oxygen by diffusion process. By diffusion process. then what will happen? Okay, observe one cell. Next, oxygen entered into the cell. Oxygen entered into the cell. This oxygen is involved in the cellular respiration. Is involved in cellular respiration. Then glucose is converted into the carbon dioxide, water and energy. Observe carefully. This is important one here. Okay. Cellular respiration is carried out by this entered oxygen. This is your conduction of the air in leaves of the plant. Okay. This is about leaves. How gases are entered into each and every cell of the leaf from the atmosphere. Observe once all the conduction process. Hello, parts of the leaf already discussed. Okay, this is a cuticle. This is the upper epidermis. This is this layer. Okay, this region is palatal parenchyma. Here, spongy parenchyma. Here, lower epidermis. This is cuticle. This stomata. These two are God cells. Understanding? This is the vascular bundle. This is xylem. This is phloem. Okay, already we discussed about TS of the leaf in photosynthesis chapter, means nutrition, first chapter. Okay, next. Thank you.
Okay, next. Conduction of the air in stem. Conduction of the air in stem. Already we discussed in stem gaseous exchange process takes place through lenticels. Through lenticels. Okay. For example, thank you. observe,
when we observe the lenticels, these are some regions where parenchyma of tissue is present. Whereas instead of the corpuscles, instead of corpuscles, regions where parenchyma cells are present, where parenchyma cells or parenchyma is present. These are usually lenticels. When we observe the lenticels, here also we can observe air space. Next, this air space is also lined with the water film. Observe carefully. Here also water is present in the eight spaces. Next, whenever atmospheric air is entered into the eight spaces through these lenticels, then atmospheric air is dissolved in water or water film. Dissolved in water film. Then here also say diffusion process takes place. What? Diffusion process takes place because of diffusion from water film. Oxygen is diffused into the cells. From cells, carbon dioxide is diffused into the water film. From water film, carbon dioxide is released into the atmospheric air. Okay, this is very important mechanism here. From the surrounding cells, oxygen is transported to all cells. Here, from the all cells, carbon dioxide is collected and that is ultimately entered into the atmospheric air. Observe. Here also diffusion plays very important role. From the water film into the adjacent cells, from these cells to other cells, from here to into the all cells of the stem. Like this. Understanding. Important. Observe. This is conduction of air in stem. Conduction of air in stem. Next, conduction of air in root, in root. Conduction of air in root. Okay, observe. This is root hair. These are soil particles. Between the soil particles, we can observe the air spaces are filled with air, atmospheric air. Observe here what will happen. From the atmospheric air, listen carefully. Actually, walls of the root hair are very thin in nature, very thin. Through these very thin walls of the root hair, oxygen is diffused into the root hair cells. Carbon dioxide is diffused out of the root hair cells into the air spaces present between the soil particles. Means here directly through the root hair, surface of the root hair. Listen carefully. Through surface of the root hair, oxygen and carbon dioxide are diffused between the air spaces and root hair cells. Root hair. Are you understanding? Observe carefully. Oxygen is entered into the root hair. Carbon dioxide is released out. Carbon dioxide is released out. Are you understanding? Next, what will happen? Next, from the root hair, oxygen is diffused to all the cells present in root. You know, soil particle. For example, this is a soil particle. Imagine around the soil particle, around the soil particle actually water is present. Around the soil particle water film is present. This water is called capillary water. What? Capillary water. Plants absorb the only capillary water from the soil. Most of the means maximum amount of water absorbed by plant is from the capillary water. Understanding? For example, observe this is soil particle. Around the soil particle, water is present. Here also same. Usually some oxygen is dissolved in this water. From this water, dissolved oxygen can be diffused into the adjacent root hair cell. For example, this is root hair. From here, oxygen is diffused into the root hair. Observe carefully. Like this, in stem, in root, in leaf, air is transported or air is conducted to each and every cell. After entering into the each and every cell of the plant, that entered oxygen is utilized in cellular respiration to produce the energy. Then after cellular respiration, liberated energy is utilized by cells of the plant to perform different types of metabolic activity like photosynthesis process, nitrogen metabolism, depends. Lipid synthesis, protein synthesis, any other all physiological or life process. Perform all life process, this liberated energy is utilized by the plant. Are you understanding? Observe carefully. This is conduction of air in plant. Conduction of air in plant. Are you understanding? Okay, observe one.